Welcome, everyone. My name is Mike A. Devil, and my dad is going to blow your mind.
Nailed it, Mark! Top!
There are 19,000 cities in the United States of America. And the question that I get is, man, how do you choose which cities to invest in? And even which cities to narrow down your research so you can do concrete research to choose which ones to invest in. If you've had that question or are wondering about that question, this video will help. I'm gonna walk you through the steps that you need to take to dial in where to invest so that you can do some concrete research. Stay tuned. Choosing a market is a necessity, and it's super important for a bunch of different reasons. First off, if the target market is undefined, your deal pipeline is gonna be unmanageable. If your target market's too large, right, it'll be impossible to gain the true level of understanding that you need to make educated investment decisions. That could happen a number of different ways. It could happen from trying to focus on the entirety of a massive city, or too many small to medium-sized cities. So, I'll tell you this, as a company we just finished reading, we read a book every month. The book that we just read was Outwitting the Devil by Napoleon Hill, which is an amazing book. If you have not read it, you should read it. And in short, I'll tell you a major takeaway after reading it again, which is this, and I talk about this all the time, God's greatest gift is giving us the ability to choose. On the flip side, Satan's greatest tool is distraction and doubt because it causes indecision. In other words, disorder and destruction are death. But fear not, my friends, because today's drip will save you from that death. You're welcome. You just thank me later, whatever you need to do, okay? So the questions that we're going to cover today, an answer for you today. How many markets should you build teams up in? Where should those, you know, target markets be? How many markets should you research? And then lastly, I'll give you some of my favorite reports, resources to help you with some of that. So question number one, right? How many markets should you build teams in? Initially, I recommend selecting one target market, two tops. And then as you gain experience and success, you can expand to multiple target markets. Okay, question number two, how many markets should you research? Okay, my suggestion is to research no more than 7 to 10 markets. And then also to answer question number three, where should those target markets be located? I'll give you four categories to help you dial in your research so that you can get more niche specific. And you can write these down, okay? Category number one, it should be the city that you currently live in. You can learn so much from your own backyard. Category number two, choose a city that's located within a 1 to 3 hour drive, something that is easily accessible. And then category number three, choose a couple areas that you're semi-familiar with, okay? Maybe you have family or friends who live there. Maybe you grew up there. Maybe you went to school there. Or maybe you've even just visited that city a whole bunch of times. Great, choose a couple of those. And then category number four is choose a couple more areas that pique your interest for any given reason. You know, these could be cities that you pull from some of the research even that I'll, you know, the research sites that I'll give you next. But they could also be found by simply Googling things like top apartment markets to invest in, markets with the most job growth, or the, you know, markets with the fastest growing cities in the US, stuff like that. So question number four is where to look for markets that pique your interest. So I'll give you my three favorite reports: Marcus & Millichap's annual investment forecast, CBRE's annual cap rate survey, and then the Milken Institute's top performing market report. So Marcus & Millichap's annual investment forecast, I read this thing religiously, okay? It provides a ranking of major US markets using a number of economic and political factors that affect apartments. CBRE's annual cap rate survey is super important because it provides an analysis of cap rate and return data for US markets. And cap rates are important because they play a big role in the cost of multifamily properties. And then lastly, the Milken Institute, their top performing markets report. Once again, it's one that I look at religiously. So what they do is they rank the top 200 markets in the US and then compare them year over year. So my advice is this: look for markets that are cracking the top 100 for the first time, or markets that have made a major jump in the rankings. You know, for example, Columbia, South Carolina, which is an area where we own a bunch of properties, jumped, I think it was like 51 spots in 2021. And we got in early, and over the coming drips, I'll tell you how to do that as well. But there you go, my friends. Hopefully those are some tools. Hopefully you took some notes on those and found some value and have some actionable steps to help you dial in an investment market. But I'm gonna tell you this, that's just the tip of the iceberg, okay? Remember, this information will help you really choose the top 7 to 10 markets that you're going to go do research on. So whether you are an active investor or a passive investor, step one, I want you to list out 5 to 6 cities from the 3 categories I explained. Number 2, I want you to find and read the reports that I mentioned. We'll make sure to add those links. And then number 3, list out 3 to 4 additional cities that pique your interest from those reports for any given reason. And then 4, reach out to local experts for more information. You know, you could call the Economic Development Committee, ask them what they're doing to attract jobs. You can call brokers, property managers, lenders, other real estate professionals in the area. You'll get tons of advice from them as well. So hopefully I lived up to Marley's expectations and blew your mind a little bit. I don't know, she's easier to blow her mind. So I love her to death for that. But I'm gonna leave you with this quote by Tim Grover's new book, Winning, okay? Which is this: most people worry about how long something will take. Winners just keep going until it gets done. Now, I wanna clarify what that means though, because it certainly doesn't mean to take your time. It means that if you want to win, you have to treat this like a marathon, treat this marathon like a sprint. No matter how long the race is, you have to treat every step as if it's the most important. You wanna know why? Because it is. So my friends, whatever you're chasing in life, whatever that is, it's not an option to sit back, skip a few days, think about it for a month, and then you know what? See how you feel in a year. It's about doing things consistently with purpose and focus from start to finish. All right, my friends, hopefully you gained some good insight there to help you dial in those 7 to 10 cities. If so, or if not, click, subscribe, like, follow, rate, subscribe, share, all that stuff that you know you're supposed to do anyway, okay? Go make it happen. We'd love it if you'd share the show so we can get more and more and provide more and more value to you as listeners. Aloha.